Hi, I'm Aparna Sood. I work in the film industry as a production designer. A production designer is responsible for designing the look of the film, which includes the color palettes, which includes your sets and your... It could be locations, it could be building up sets from the scratch. It includes every single thing that you see in a frame, which are the props other than the costumes, though the costumes are a part of our palette, but we are not directly responsible for them. I was born, brought up in Simla. I studied in Loreto Convent Tara Hall, after which I switched to art and did an interior designing course while doing my graduation in Chandigarh. Because I was from Simla and it had all the British architecture around, I was always very fascinated with buildings and designing, and there was this famous Indian Institute of Advanced Studies, which I think is one of my favorite places. And I think from there is where I was inspired to do something in design or something in architecture. My interior designing course was a year long. It gave me the basics, but whatever I've learned about designing has been on the job. I did start working really early with an architect when I was in my second year of graduation, and that's how I started my small steps towards being a production designer. I started working with an architect when I was 19 years old. He was an architect in Simla. His name was Mr. Negi. He used to do designing for the... We used to be a firm which was designing for the government that time. It was the beginning of my professional career. I used to get these big blueprints which I had to literally copy as a drafts person. So that really taught me a lot. So working with an architect was a great thing, because even if you're not formally educated, because it teaches you a lot more than what you can learn in an interior designing course. It taught me a lot about construction, it taught me a lot about structures, which helps me still when I'm doing my production design work and building bigger sets. I moved to Bombay in 2002. I was looking for a job in an architectural firm. My sister was already here working as an animator. She's the one who first introduced me to this term, which was production designer. I had no clue what production designing was or what art direction was. I met my first boss, I think the day I'd arrived in Bombay. The next day I got a meeting with my first boss to assist him. First set that I ever saw was a beach set, which had fake clouds, a fake sun glowing with sand on the floor, and there was a song happening. So I went to meet him on a set, and that's how my journey started, and I just knew that this was what I wanted to do. With Guruji, I did a couple of films. For 3 years I was working with him. I learned a lot from him, after which I started freelancing. I did a film as a prop master, I did a film as a set dresser, and I got my first break as a production designer / an art director with Ram Gopal Varma. I did 8 films with him back to back as a production designer. Over the course of my career, I've done 32 films as a production designer, assistant art director, prop master, as a set dresser. My most recognizable film is Neerja, for which I won the Filmfare, the IFA and the Zee. I built a plane from scratch, a Boeing 737 from scratch. I lost one of the awards of that year is because the judges thought that it was a real plane that the film was shot in. When I became a production designer, there were no courses for production designing. Currently, there are lots of options. If you can afford it, please go abroad and do these fancy courses in London and LA and New York. But in India, there's FTII in Pune, which the course, I've seen the course material, it's pretty intense, and it covers everything. There's a course in Whistling Woods, which is also pretty interesting. These are the two places I'm aware of, and I've seen the material that they're teaching, and I feel that it's worth it's the course is worth it. If somebody's had a different career and would like to switch to a production design, there's no formal training that we need in our industry. This is probably the best thing and the worst thing in our industry, that we don't need any formal training to be a producer, director or anything. If you're good with what you are doing, if you can manage things, you will probably excel in it. We've got people from the road becoming the best directors, the best camera people, the best production designers, everything. So there's no requisite like this. We don't need a degree in our hand to enter industry. But yes, I feel that any kind of education related to design, art, to architecture will definitely help you in your production design. But if you want to switch from a corporate career, you're most welcome and you can probably try it. Nobody can stop you. It's a lot of struggle in the beginning. It's a lot of hard work, which is now still, but I think the finances do match up to it. If you're starting and if you have no formal training, you'll have to intern with a production designer for a couple of months. This could pay you nothing or could pay you a really small stipend. A production designer as a career has a lot of sections. So you can either pursue art direction, which involves the construction, design, like the layouts and everything, or you could be a set dresser, you could be a prop master, you could be a coordinator. So you can decide on whichever line you would like to pursue in the beginning. And then once you've learned the one skill, I think the finances will keep getting better as you become better with the line that you picked up. I love my job actually. It's, you know, the best part about our jobs, which is it's not mundane at all. We do something different every day. You're designing something different every single day. You will put it on paper today. In 3 days, it's built in front of you. So in architectural, the only thing I feel, I've tried doing architectural projects and interior designing projects. They get a little slow for me because it takes a lot of time to finish it. So what advantage I have being a production designer is whatever I'm designing, I think the maximum it'll take me 3 months is to build. It could be a palace, it could be a plane, it could be a fancy house, it could be anything that you can think about, but it's up and about like very soon for you to see what you actually put on paper. Our job starts by reading the script, understanding it, and then converting my director's vision of the script into my sets or my locations, into every prop that I'm using, into every single thing that you see in the frame. We have to decide as to what locations, which is also a part of our job, if it can be shot, if it has to be shot in actual location, or do we have to manufacture some sets for it. This is our first discussion which happens with the director. That's how we move forward. We then decide the color palette of our film. We design our palettes, we design our sets, we design locations which need adaption according to the script. That's how we move forward. This is done in the pre-production stage. This could take a couple of months or a couple of days depending on the size of your project and the size of the film that you are planning to make. Some sets could take 2 days, some sets could take 20 days, some sets could take 200 days also to build. Production design can be divided into two broad aspects. One is the construction and one is the decor. We have an art director and a set decorator. Art direction is basically your construction, your building, your structures. And the second side is the set decoration, which includes your entire propping, your referencing, researches, designing, and everything else. So understanding your characters is very important. How the sets would describe that character is a very important aspect of production design. If your set can tell a story about the character is when you've built a good set. Once we've decided on the locations or set adaptions or location adaptions, we then sit on our designs in detail. Designs can be presented to the director through 3D softwares, through models. How can you interpret what the director's vision is through your sets is the most important thing. Our job gets over once the shoot is over. The edit and all, we are not a part of the edit and all. So the future for production design, I would say, is a lot of VFX. There's a collaborating with your VFX team. We are going to be I think building less and working a lot with our with green screens and with extending sets. It's been happening a lot in Hollywood already. In India, we are not very like, I would say that we are still exploring the idea. I think that will be the next big thing in our industry.
If you found this video helpful, subscribe to our channel for more career videos every week. Leave your comments on careers you would like to watch, and we will try our best to help you find your stride.